Thank you, Mr. Billam. At this time, I'd like to bring up our life management teacher, Mrs. Angela Tulaski, and she will present our second student of the month.
Good evening, Board of Education administrators and the rest of the community that has joined us tonight. I have nominated Grace Glenn as the Life Management Student of the Month. There are many words that I would use to describe Grace. She is dedicated to school, always gives 100%. She's friendly, caring, trustworthy, and respectful. She is self-motivated and continually strives for excellence. She's helpful in the classroom and with fellow classmates. A month ago, a fellow classmate who is also a senior was discussing her concerns about paying for college and her concerns about finding scholarships. Grace overheard her and the next day showed up with a gigantic current scholarship book that her mother had purchased for her and shared that with her. And I just thought that went above and beyond just being the fellow classmate that she is. I'd also like to take a moment to thank her parents, David and LaShonda. We all know that hardworking and respectful students start at home, so thank you very much. Grace is a senior who will go out into the world and become an asset wherever she goes. Grace, it's been a pleasure having you in all of my classes.
Harmon's choice of project was
was to write, entirely in German, an origin story for many of the villains from the Brothers Grimm fairy tales, in which she also incorporated elements from Indian mythology and origami. The end result of the project was well written, entertaining, and stood out as one of the most creative projects I've ever seen from a student. Harman is an especially great choice for our World Language Student of the Month because he has not only studied German, he has conversational skills in Punjabi, Hindi, and Urdu, and has also studied French while at LCN. His French teacher, Marie Howard, cannot be here tonight, but asked me to include the following. Harman is always prepared, respectful, and on task. He strives to achieve his best and is one of the top students in the Level 3 French class. Last year, Harman went above and beyond and took French 2 as an 8th hour so that he could keep all of his AP classes and continue learning French. He has great control of the French language, and this is evident in his speaking, listening, reading, and writing skills. He is very deserving of this award. Harman is very deserving of being the World Language Student of the Month for high school North. I'm so glad to have been able to teach him. I can't wait to see what he does with learning language in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The leadership in the classrooms that make the difference. That's what makes successful and participating and working with families. That's what makes a difference in Lance Cruz. So I'm going to thank all the students that came here tonight for the opportunity to see your families and to see our staff come in, because that's something that helps us understand what we're really here for. So thank you very much and congratulations.
Along with this rebranding, it should be noted that officially the name of the facility has been the Diane Pellerin Center since it opened in 2009. However, within the district, it has commonly been referred to as Riverside or Riverside Academy. Along with this information you're about to hear, the staff and students would like to reaffirm the program and facility as the Pellerin Center for Pellerin. Mr. Wolfowski is going to take it over for us.
Well, thank you this evening. I would like to first ask that my student council representatives and Ms. Jackie Warren just join me up here at the podium. again, thank the Board of Education and our central office administrators, as well as our patrons here this evening for an honest time tonight for the presentation for the Pellerin Center. Many of you might know that the Pellerin Center has been in existence for alternative education purposes for quite a few years. Over the course of my tenure and being a proud administrator of this very special program, we developed and kind of evolved from what alternative education students related to prior to the Pellerin Center being built and us taking occupancy of it. So this evening I was going to take the opportunity to kind of walk through the alternative and adult education programs, and then at the end provide you a very special video that was created by our student council president to give you a glimpse of what the day looks like for Pellerin Center students. And then again, should give you some of the accolades that we have experienced together over the last couple of years. Together this evening with myself, I am presenting on behalf of the student council and the student council representative, Ms. Jackie Warner, who is our staff representative. Our student council members that are joining us this evening are President Sierra Rosen. Representative Tyler Amelia. Our purpose this evening is to provide a small amount of background into our alternative program, as well as to present the student centered recommendation to the Board of Education and central office personnel. For the last couple of years, students at the Pellerin Center have been researching and exploring ideas in an attempt to correctly identify their image. As a student at the Pellerin Center, this effort has resulted in a recommendation this evening to reinvent the mascot of the alternative education program and that they are associated with. As you may know, the Riverside Academy, also known as the Ravens, has been associated with Lance Cruz Schools for many years as the adult education program at many locations. The Pellerin Center officially opened for students in the fall of 2009. The mascot, the Ravens, was a standing mascot for the Riverside Academy located in downtown Mount Clemens. Some of you might know this location now as the Center of Lifelong Learning for Adult Education. I'm going to give you a closer look at the Lance Cruz and Adult Alternative Programs. The Center of Lifelong Learning is located on North River Road in downtown Mount Clemens, formerly known as the home of the Ravens Riverside Academy. At this program, it is the mission statement for the adult program. It is a collaborative community focused on continuous improvement to ensure students achieve individual and academic and social success. The collaboration still stands with Mount Clemens Community Schools as well as Lakeshore Public Schools. The points of pride for the program, we offer GED and high school completion programs for students of the ages of 18 through 19, also adult education through students 20 years of age and older. Adult basic education, GED, high school completion programs are available day and evening. Some may not know that Lance Cruz education still is offered, especially here in correctional education purposes, at the Macomb County Jail. We do have three instructors and one support staff that command the county jail program daily to offer education to individuals who may request it while inside or incarcerated. The points of pride here are being the adult basic education program and GED prep, again for incarcerated individuals. However, now gained the opportunity to start testing GED inside the county jail program, which we are still evolving with, but allowed to make educational gains regardless of their position. The Diane M. Pellerin Center, which is located across the street here on Pinkow Boulevard, houses our alternative education high schools. The high schools here, our students here that participate in the Pellerin Center are referred to us for academic reasoning and for intervention. The students come from all communities that surround the Lance Cruz Public School District, are formerly from Lance Cruz North, Lance Cruz High School, and Fraser High School is currently contracted with our program to send students each year. Some of the points of pride across the street at the alternative high school. We're currently serving, as I said, Fraser Public Schools in contract. We provide student transportation from all over this area. Students are encouraged to participate in organized sports, either home schools at Lance Cruz or Lance Cruz North. We do offer unique course offerings at Dollar Center, including drama, 2D and 3D art, communications courses, publications, stagecraft, and performance. We do offer small class sizes. It does separate us from the rest by offering this class small class sizes. Online courses are offered, allowing students to complete any class that's needed, regardless of scheduling availability. And we do have an intimate setting of just about 300 students and 30 staff members that show up daily across the street. One of the biggest points of pride for our building is becoming NCAA certified last year, 2014, which continuing effort by our staff to make sure we are offering education at the highest level to our students and Lance Cruz. We have that certified through 2019, which we are eagerly awaiting our next visit. Just for a quick overrun of the program, we have a program that has envisioned the verbal hot. And if anybody's a Disney fan, you will understand that Lilo and Stitch coined the phrase Ohana as a Hawaiian term, say it right, which is a Hawaiian term that means family. Family means, in our case, no one is left behind. Throughout the high school, you'll see across there the Ohana phrase will be worn. You'll see a screw across the building. And we actually do a PBS-style positive behavior support recognition for students that exhibit family qualities inside the building each day. The alternative setting, we do have our own graduation ceremony, which takes place down at the PayPal Center each June, and we graduate approximately 100 to 125 students from Lance Cruz Public School each year. Again, I want to reset the purpose over here for this evening, giving you a little background on the program itself. About 4 years ago, when I had the pleasure to join the staff over at the Coloring Center, the students charged me with a seemingly hard task, which was to re-identify themselves and to properly show how they've been involved as a student, how they want to be recognized. 2.5 years of work, lots of research, lots of exploration, and lots of student voting has come to a conclusion tonight. That's why we're here to present to you the reinvention of what the students believe the Coloring Center is and how they should be represented. The Ravens was the old mascot, which came up with us as we changed buildings. However, through this process, the students have identified a new mascot to the point where we have discussed this for the past couple years in central office, again, taking it to the student body for voting, come up with a new school color and a new design for a mascot, which the students feel that they can relate to, and then feel that it better represents them at the student body. And I believe the culture of learning at the Coloring Center will be greatly increased by utilizing the students' input and their creativity. So this process, which again was created by students, I steered them the best I could, encouraged them where I could, but again, this was all student-based, this was all student-motivated. The product this evening comes from the creativity of the students at the Coloring Center. That being said, I'd like to share with you just a brief video created by our student council president that kind of gives you a glimpse into the day of life at the Coloring Center.
Welcome to our building, the
Diane
Coloring Center. I'm Sierra Roberson. I'm the Student Council President. Let's meet the rest of our Student Council representatives. This is Ms. Jackie, our staff representative. We'd like to show you our real day at the Coloring Center. Ready? Here come the students now. Ready to start their school day. There's Ms. McGuire. And here comes Malik, late as usual, and ready for his practice. Ooh, look, the line's short right now. This is Ms. Brenda, wearing her Ohana shirt. And in case you didn't know, Ohana means family. And here at the Coloring Center, we're a real family. Time for class. First is Mr. Weary's PE class. Wow, they pedal fast. This is our achievement tree on our way to Mr. Corning's English class. This is Ms. Palmer Carey's science class on the second floor. Quick stop at the art room. Now on to my favorite classroom, Ms. Jackie's drama room. This is our media center. Now on to our math intervention room. There's Ashley. She just got a great grade on her math paper in Mr. Sanborn's class. Last class of the day, our Plato lab, where students can move at their own pace. Wow, the day's over already? Time to go home. But wait, there's more. These are some fun memories from the school year. Field trips, Spirit Week, Halloween, our drama play at Green Elementary, our amazing race, and some just hanging out.
I hope you can see how much I love our program, and I hope you enjoy this insight into our school day. But the real reason we've made this presentation is because our staff and students have all voted to elect a new mascot and color that better represent our school. Our program has evolved, and our image is changing. We like our mascot to reflect that. As student council president, I'm asking you to approve this change. I really hope you do, because we have teachers here.
And again, I was requested by the student council to speak on their behalf. The video was created because I believe some of us had some apprehension about speaking in front of large groups that have been at the Board of Education. But I'm going to take this moment to say that working for an alternative setting is one of the most rewarding experiences I can ever produce to you or put into words. The students there are amazing. The staff are exceptional. The daily rewards that you receive as a student and or staff member in the building are beyond compare. This evening's presentation was 2 years worth of work that the student council put in, countless attempts to get the student body behind them with an overall majority vote on a mascot that best suits them and the color that they're all proud to wear. Tonight they actually prepared the t-shirts in advance with the confidence that the board would be happy with their work. I know I am, and I had the confidence behind it as well. But I just wanted to say thank you to the Board of Education, thank you to Central Office employees for supporting the program. That reaches every learner in Lancaster's public schools. We continue to strive for the best. We continue to improve our facility and our academic performance. There is no ceiling on the Culinary Center as far as I'm concerned. There's only growth. So I would like to, myself, let's take a step aside, knowing that the words I use tonight were only to benefit the individuals behind me because the effort is theirs. But I do want to recognize Ms. Jackie Warner and Student Council for some extraordinary efforts. Reminder to the board that the t-shirts you provided are alternate sizes in your boardroom that you're available to exchange the appropriate size. We did not take that time tonight. Again, but thank you very much for allowing us this time on your agenda this evening.
At the beginning of the year, all the board members were asked what we looked forward to for this year. And I was looking forward to this. We heard rumblings from the Pelham program of the students taking leadership, please. And this expressed, couldn't be any prouder than the leadership and what this represents as part of the student body and the schools. Congratulations, great work.
And your mascot is?
I don't know, because I must have missed the slide. Well, they say they don't need a microphone, so I guess I need to use it. But again, the slide that I did miss is from now on you'll understand that the clerical staff support staff, as well as myself, is going to recognize across the street that Riverside Academy we left behind in downtown Mount Clemens, the Pelham Center is now the home of the Phoenix. So.
Let's take a 7-minute break, so we'll start back at 7:37.